Today's video is going to be about my experiences during undergrad studying mathematics. Now, I did do a double major in physics and maths, and I've already made a video called My Regrets Studying Physics, so I thought it would only be fair to make this one. To start off, I'll tell you some things that I definitely don't regret about studying maths. Number one would be that I don't regret the time that I spent studying. So I don't regret the time that I spent studying and learning mathematical ideas instead of anything else that I could have been doing, whether it's going out and partying or doing any other activity. I don't regret that I spent a lot of that time studying. I also don't regret any of the people that I've met whilst I've been pursuing maths, whether it was like lecturers or students in my class and my peers. I've really enjoyed some of the friendships I've made through math classes, and in fact some of my best friends have come from there. So let's talk about some of the things that I do regret, and this is actually pretty nuanced because I would say overall I'm glad I majored in mathematics. I think it's a good major and I definitely got a lot out of it. This is just inviting over a Captain Hindsight to see a few things that I guess I feel not the greatest about. So the first would be thinking that I was good at math just because I'd done a course on it or because I could get a good grade in that course. I also had a lot of confusion between getting a good grade on something and that meaning that I actually enjoyed it. What I mean is that I sort of felt like sometimes more than I enjoyed maths, I just enjoyed the satisfaction of getting a good grade on something or the feeling that I could get from doing maths that had nothing to do with maths at all. And that was more about my personal craving to do something that satisfied me and to get, you know, instant satisfaction in a way that doing like a maths assignment, especially the low-hanging fruit or the easy problems in math, can give you. You know, if you can apply some of these ideas that you've learned, do the homework problem, hand it in, and get feedback pretty quickly afterwards, it kind of feels good and it feels like you're accomplishing something. It feels good to just to be able to finish something. That's what I'm especially talking about, these sort of low-hanging fruit problems in math. They really gave me this sense of satisfaction. And I guess I enjoyed that. I enjoyed feeling like I was good at something, and I think it was good for my like self-confidence. But I think I confused that feeling I got from math with actually enjoying it, because sometimes I didn't enjoy it at all, but it was just masked up by this feeling that, oh well, I got a good grade, so I must be really enjoying and I must be passionate about the subject, when sometimes I wasn't. Don't get me wrong, there are some areas of math I really do enjoy. For example, I found my dynamical systems course really interesting, but then there were some courses that I took, I think, for other reasons. Maybe one of those other reasons was to like stroke my own ego. Like, I would take courses that I thought were notoriously difficult just because I felt like I should take that challenge and that people taking those courses were seen to be the best at maths, and maybe it was the perception that I wanted other people to believe I was good at maths as well. So I feel like maybe not all the choices I made in terms of which classes I picked and everything like that, where I put my effort, was made based on what I actually enjoyed, but it was based on other things. It was based on what I thought I was good at from these arbitrary grades and measures, and it was based on what I thought was perceived as like the best math to be doing or the most prestigious math to be doing, when really none of those things mattered as much. So at the time I guess I'd been a little bit more aware of what I actually enjoyed and what I didn't. My second regret is probably thinking that some of the math was more abstract than it really was. I was presented with a lot of these really abstract ideas in math, and one thing about them is that they're very hard, I guess, to show to people who are outside of mathematics completely and have them understand what's going on. So it kind of creates this feeling of like an elite little club of people who are in this math class and they understand something that kind of very few other people understand, and it's kind of a big barrier to entry as well sometimes when it comes to math. So there were a lot of these abstract ideas, and I guess I didn't ever really put much effort into trying to communicate them to other people, and I would often maybe brush them off as just being crazily complex math ideas that you'd never understand unless you're in this class. But it also affected my own thinking about these ideas. I guess sometimes I felt like certain exercises and problems that I was working on only existed in this strange realm, which consisted of the lecturer's own mind, my notes, and then on the exam. And the problems didn't seem to exist anywhere outside of this. And that affected the way that I thought about them. I found them not so interesting or important, and I only studied for them in a way that I was good at answering them on the exam, but didn't have much knowledge about these problems to apply outside of that context. That lack of understanding of the bigger picture of some of these math ideas is one of my regrets. And actually, I realized it from an unlikely source, and it was from a VSource video. I think the video I remember is called like the brachistochrone, and it's actually about finding the quickest way that you can fall between two points. But the fact is that VSource made this really cool video about this idea and linking it to all these other physical ideas, and it was a really cool video. And I was thinking, like, I have actually done lots of problems before on this subject, this brachistochrone, in math class and physics class, and I never actually realized it was cool. I never thought about it as being interesting in this context for other people, and I kind of realized that a lot of the ideas I'd studied were actually interesting outside of the context of the exam, but I'd never been able to see that before. I've since seen a lot of other videos. Someone like 3 Blue 1 Brown presents math ideas, and I watch them and I think, wow, this is actually interesting. These ideas are actually interesting. These ideas that I've learned about at uni but never cared about. I wished that I'd seen a lot of these deeper meanings at the time and actually used them to be more engaged with what I was learning. Again, sure, I did appreciate some things. I mean, I managed to get through the math degree, so I had some amount of inspiration behind me. And what I'm doing now on YouTube, I think you can see that I do have a passion for math somewhere down there, but it's definitely been very small at times and has come and gone. But I really feel like it wasn't until after I finished a lot of these courses that I realized these ideas were actually cool, and that I probably should have spent more time trying to understand how I could communicate them to other people, because it would have helped me appreciate that they were cool. So those are my thoughts here. It's just based on my personal experience, so let me know if you can relate to any of these ideas. And as always, thanks for watching.